neutral side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The kickers got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He's out to the 30. He's tackled to the 38-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. They'll bring him down to the 37-yard line.
Well, I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he's stopped before he even gets going.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. Now he's scrambling. Tackle made around the 40-yard line. That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8. Stopped in the backfield.
Did you see how quickly he was able to get into the backfield and make that tackle? Not many guys that big can move that fast.
Dixon awaits the snap. Oh, excellent punt. He's taken down at the 22. The Rams have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Braz, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
2nd and 7. Ball on the 24-yard line.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
Third and one. Ball on the 31-yard line. And he hits him hard at the 34. Short gain there by the tailback, and he's still going to come away with a first down.
You like how the offense is playing intelligent, controlled football here, using the safe run to get the first.
Tailback broke that one for a very nice game.
Give the offensive line some kudos there. They blocked very well up front to create the holes for this back.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. Run left side, and he carries the ball for a nice game. From the 42-yard line, first down. And he throws it away. And this is the 8th play of the drive. He's under pressure. And he got it to the sophomore. And they make the stop around the 31-yard line. from the 31-yard line. First down. Taken down around the 23-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Gets out to about the 21. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. Run by the halfback to find the end zone.
Good play call here by the offensive coordinator. He realizes when you get down into the red zone and you have a halfback like this, just give him the ball and let him find his way into the end zone.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. An 11-play, 78-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. They line up to kick this one away.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And he's taken down right around the 28-yard line. We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 28-yard line. Caught out of the open. That's a 3-yard pickup.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
From their own 31-yard line. Third down. Now he tries to buy some time. And he is drilled at the 35-yard line. And they picked up 4 yards on the scramble. Dixon to punt. Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. Hands off to the left and they wrestle him down behind the line. Quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. The Rams lead 7-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Play action. Around the 44-yard line.
Well, you give up too many passes like that, and the game will be done before you know it. They cannot let these receivers get behind them.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Motion. He makes his way to about the 48.
That'll bring up second and three.
Two ties.
He has some room. And he's tackled right around the 34.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
From the 34-yard line, first down. Can't get away. Nice tackle.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
From the 16-yard line, first down. Tackle at about the 17-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Third down and 12. Ball on the 18-yard line. Five wide. The 10. Quick throw out to the receiver. And down he goes at the 9-yard line.
We've got a change at the quarterback position. You've got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning.
Kick is up, and it's good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 32. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Nice run up the middle.
That brings up second and five.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. Catches it, and that's all. And they get 5 yards from that completion.
Not a bad play. They gain 5 yards out of it. They keep moving the defense back.
Runs it, and oh, what a hit.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. And down he goes at the 34-yard line.
Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Out of bounds, right around the 36-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 36. defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he's leveled at the 48-yard line. From their own 48-yard line, it's first down. Quick pass, and he tackles him hard at the 41.
That makes it first and 10.
Just throws this one away. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. And he just gets rid of it. They tried to fool him by running the same play again.
Well, fooled no one there, Brad.
Job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
He's out of bounds at the 17-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. To about the 14-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back.
Here, the receiver needs to do a better job of holding his block on the corner, or there's no place for the ball carrier to go. This quarterback is tough as nails. Brad, he's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
He gets it up, and he's got it. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Six-yard line. The Mustangs will use their first time out of the half. From their own 36-yard line, first down. Slings it. That's a great tackle at the 41-yard line. Pearson picks up about 5 yards on that hookup. The Mustangs use their second time out. They come out on an empty backfield. He's going to try and scramble. He's at midfield. Tackle made around the 43-yard line.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
Dumps it complete over the middle. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Locked down in the open field.
You've got to play with that kind of purpose to move the ball against this defense.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. He's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Locked down at about the 7-yard line. The Mustangs, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. It's up, and it is good. Well, we played a half of football. The Rams with a 10-point lead.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Take a look at both quarterbacks in this game, and neither one of them even has their pants dirty. Nobody's been on the ground here. No pressure generated by the defense, but one of the reasons is because quarterbacks have been able to get rid of the football. Maybe a little help in the secondary to those guys trying to rush the pass.
The guys up front always get the blame, but it really is a business that works hand in hand, because you can get a lot of sacks off garbage sacks where it's great coverage down the field, but the quarterback has to hold it for 4 or 5 seconds. But it works the other way around too. If somebody's open every time he pats that football and reaches the top of his drop, I can't get there in time. So the coverage needs to tighten up a little bit, mess up the rhythm, jam the receivers maybe a little bit more. Give me a little bit of time so those big boys up front can get to the quarterback.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They're set to go for another round. The stop
at about the 43-yard line.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8. That makes it 2nd and 2. Himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
From the 27-yard line, first down. Zips it to the back. He's taken down at the 25-yard line. Catch there before he stepped out of bounds. From the 15-yard line, it's first down. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
Defense and their short yardage package. And he's taken down at the 3. This is the 8th play of this drive. Play action. Finds a man. Touchdown. So they go to the air and they come away with 6, Kirk.
Man, Brad, I got to tell you, that's not an easy thing to do there. The defenses nowadays are so tough when you get inside the red zone.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
first. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gets to about the 27-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
It's second down, eight to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's at midfield for the 20. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal.
Well, defense coordinator's got to be able to shake this off. I mean, it's one thing to be able to sit there and give up a big play, which they just did, but you can't dwell on it and give up another big play. That's what film study's for tomorrow. We can look at the film, and we can try to get better. But right now, they've got to be able to shake this play off and get ready to play the next down.
So after the big pass play, we have a first and goal. He's on the run, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
That brings up second and goal.
Hands it to the back. He's pushed out of bounds around the 5-yard line. It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out. Inside handoff, and he's tackled
at about the 5-yard line.
That brings us fourth and goal.
Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Rams having everything going their way right now. They have put up 20 straight points on the board.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
He's tackled around the 24-yard line.
That's not what you hope for from your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Nice play fake. Steps up. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. From the 48-yard line, first down. Two-yard loss for the halfback.
That'll bring up second and 12.
Offense lines up in a 5-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. Fires out to his receiver. Tackled right around the 42-yard line.
Third down.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. Got a receiver and he dropped it. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. Oh, one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish. Whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down close with their opponent's territory.
And down he goes at about the 17-yard line. So it's second and 13. Ball on their own 17. Fires out to his wide out, and he is drilled at the 32-yard line. The third quarter, the Rams lead 20-6. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. He's to the 40. He gets to about the 41-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Here's the halfback, and he's brought down hard behind the line. Midfield, and he jumped out of bounds at the 44-yard line. That makes it first and 10. From the 44-yard line, first down. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete. And this play is number 8 on the drive. So they're going to go for it here. Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
Here we go.
He zips it out. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Converts the extra point. Wheeler ready to kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. He's under pressure. from their own 21-yard line. Second down. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. And he's level at the 48-yard line. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Just over 2 minutes in the game.
Good shot at picking it off. It's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball in the 48. Nice run, and he's brought down. The Mustangs will use their first time out of the half. The Mustangs use their second time out.
Normally, you look for the pass in those kinds of situations, but a very alert play stopped that run short of the sticks.
Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. The Mustangs using their third and last timeout. It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard. This is the eighth play of the drive. He makes it to the 35-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 28. Stop short.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.